crest, son, right here. And look, look at that crown. I am a king. There it is right there. I've been right all along. See, that's the crown, and right there, that's Ethiopia. That's where my family came from. And right here, see, that's black and white hand intermingled. Whatever that means. And then here's a shield showing that we were great warriors.
With a Jewish star on it. If I know my Bible, and I know my Bible, you are a descendant of a king of the Jews. And if you're a king, you're also Jewish.
Jewish?
Gee, that's funny. You don't look it.
I'm Jewish.
God is white. First of all, white man, let me say that I love you, honor you, envy you, enjoy your smell, and I celebrate you in the name of white Jesus.
Thank you?
No, thank you. Look at that. That's a handsome young man, ain't it? Now, if God looked like Isaac Hayes, you think his son would look like this? That's right. Somebody out there is feeling the spirit.
I am. I am. I feel it.
If you black of skin and full of sin, come forward so I may lay my hands on you.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Black, be gone. Praise white Jesus.
So, black people are a
curse.
Yet another person claiming it's racist to have a white Santa, you know? And by the way, for all you kids watching at home, Santa just is white, but this person is just arguing that maybe we should also have a black Santa. Just because it makes you feel uncomfortable doesn't mean it has to change. You know, I mean, Jesus was a white man too, but you know, it's like he was a historical figure. I mean, that's a verifiable fact, as is Santa. I just want the kids watching to know that.
Online, guys, and I said, what color is Jesus, what color is Santa Claus, and everyone's like going crazy, what color are you, what's wrong with you? I can't believe I'm discussing this either, but that is the most responses I think I've gotten in a year on social media is when I put that question up, and when I posted something last week about someone who looked like Jesus selling Christmas trees, the internet went crazy. So Jamel, in an article that you wrote, you said that Kelly thinks that the idea of a racially inclusive Santa Claus is utterly ridiculous. And that she's wrong. Why is she wrong? Explain that.
I, I think she's wrong because there's already racially inclusive Santa Clauses. I grew up with a black Santa Claus. All of our Santas were black, all of our Mrs. Clauses were black. Like this, not every family has a white Santa, and I think that's perfectly fine. And I think Aisha Harris's idea that since there are so many different kinds of Americans, that maybe we should simply take race out of the question altogether isn't a bad one at all. I think if we're trying to err on the side of inclusivity, then definitely Penguin Santa makes sense. But to get outraged at the idea that there are non-white Santas is ridiculous, because I guarantee you right now that if you were to walk into the home of an African-American person, almost anywhere in the country, you would find a black Santa Claus and black angels and a black Jesus.
Well, I think you would find a black Santa Claus in every black home, because Santa Claus is black in black homes, and right. Santa Claus is white in white homes. Santa Claus is Mexican in Mexican homes. So let me just tell you, Santa Claus to me is a black man. Now listen, Eric, I want to ask you this. I was with her. I understood what she meant in the beginning. I think what she meant. I don't want to put words in her mouth because I've been misquoted about things and people have misinterpreted things. If you look at the depiction of Santa Claus, the popular representation of Santa Claus, if you look at Kris Kringle, then it is a white depiction. I understand that. But there are many who question the authenticity, shall we say, of Santa Claus and Jesus. Where she lost me was a Jesus thing. What do theologians say about the color of Jesus' skin?
Well, when we look at Jesus as a historical figure, you're talking about somebody from the first century who lived in the Middle East. So in all likelihood, he would have had an olive complexion. We don't really know. What we do know is how artists have depicted him over the years. And like you said, just like with Santa Claus, oftentimes cultures will, it's almost a mirror of who's doing the depiction as to what Jesus turns out. When you go to Jamaica, you see a Jamaican Jesus. When you go to countries in Asia, you'll often see an Asian-looking Jesus. And here in the United States and in North America and Europe,
I want to say that to Eric and Jamel. When you mentioned Jamel, Santa Claus and black families. I mean, you're talking about ornaments and pictures, but not at every black family's home that I went to as a kid that they had black Santas or black Jesus. There were some white Jesuses hanging up on the wall in black homes. I was researching this, I was researching Santa Claus, even in Africa, the traditional American depiction of Santa stands even in countries that are black. So isn't it kind of up to people to decide what their Santa and what their Jesus looks like, Jamel?
You know, I think that's absolutely right. I think, what your Santa, what your Jesus looks like is up to you. It's whatever you feel most comfortable with. I would agree that when you're talking about the historical Jesus, and Kelly, during her segment, she took a moment to say that, we have historical evidence of what Jesus looked like. Yeah, he was an olive-skinned man because he was from first century Palestine. He likely had close-cropped dark hair and dark eyes and looked like his peers and contemporaries. And so on that, Kelly is definitely just incorrect. She's misinformed.
Anyone who has studied the Bible and anyone who knows about the heritage or the roots of Jesus knows that he was a dark-skinned person and probably wasn't a white man. He wasn't a white man. He was a darker persuasion.
Yeah, he certainly
Eastern
didn't come
Jewish,
from,
right?
He didn't come from Europe. He didn't come from North America. That's just not where he came from. So Jesus isn't white. Saying that is just wrong.
Okay,
with all
so
due respect to Miss Kelly.
Times I have prophetic dreams, like the one where I was at a garden party. Excuse me, everyone, I have a brief announcement to make. Jesus was black, Ronald Reagan was the devil, and the government is lying about 9/11. Thank you for your time, and good night. No! That can't be true! That can't be!
Where you made the white people riot, weren't you?
But I was telling the truth.
How many times have I told you better not even dream about telling white folks the truth? You understand me? Shoot. Making white people riot. You better learn how to lie like me. I'm gonna find me a white...
Let black Jesus hang alongside.
Forget it. The only Jesus I know is him. And the one thing he don't need is a partner.
Israel,
they were supposed to be black.
I bet they were. If ever people were lost, we're it.
chef, both of you. This picture has been in my family for as long as I can remember. When I was a baby, I don't know what I saw first. My mama, my papa, or this Jesus. Now, he's the one I know and love. So let's close the subject.
Jesus was black. The Bible would have said so.
But it does say so.
What are you talking about?
I read about it. It's in Revelation chapter 1, verse 14. I read about it in Muhammad's speech. It says, his hair is like wool, and his eyes are like flame of fire.
Well, Lord, have mercy. It sure do say that, don't it?
And see, Mom, look at that hair, like wool, ain't it? And look at them eyes, red like fire.
Yeah, that it sure is. Jenny, how come you decided to paint this?
I don't know. All of a sudden, I just had divine thoughts on my mind.
And for JJ, that's a first.
What, having divine thoughts?
No, having a mind.
I guess I ought to be grateful for JJ having Jesus on his mind in any color.
Then we can hang him on the wall, Mama?
Well, now,
please, Mama.
All right. But just for Black History Week. After that, he comes down.
The thief cometh not but for to steal, and to kill, and to destroy. But I am come that they might have life, that they might have it more abundantly. St. John 10, verse 10. Are there any questions? Satan has a question.
Yes, sir, Chaplain Gill, but since neither one of us are God, I don't think either one of us are in any position to say who is good and who's evil.
Why don't you just ask your question?
We were discussing the disciples. What color were they?
Well, I don't think we know that for certain.
But they were Hebrews, were they not?
That's right.
As was Jesus. Jesus was also a Hebrew.
Why don't you just ask your question?
What color were the original Hebrews?
I have told you that we don't know that for certain.
Then you can't believe for certain that Jesus was white. Just a moment.
God is white. Isn't it obvious?
Well, that is obvious, but we don't know if it's obvious that God is white. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad teaches us that Jesus did not have blonde hair and blue eyes. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad teaches us that the images of Jesus that are on prison walls and churches throughout the world are not historically correct. Because history teaches us that Jesus was born in a region where the people had color.
There's proof in the very Bible that you ask us to read in Revelation 1st chapter, verse 14 and 15, that Jesus had hair like wool and feet the color of bread.
But just what are you saying?
I'm not saying anything. I'm proving to you that Jesus was not,
and I might quote one of our Indian brothers, he was not a pale face.